The topic is the linear regression. So let's do this example. We examine the relationship between the fuel economy miles per gallon and horsepower for 15 models of cars. Further analysis produces the regression model, miles per gallon expected. So this is expected or predicted miles per gallon. Predicted miles per gallon is equal 46.87 minus 0.084 horsepower. This is the number of horsepower the car has or the engine has. Horsepower. All right. It says if the car you are thinking of buying has 200 horsepower. So think of this as this is your X. So this is the X value and this is Y hat. I mean, the definition is right here. Y hat is equal B0 plus B1X. So if the car you are thinking of buying has a 200 horsepower, so in other words, if X is equal 200, what does this model suggest your gas mileage would be? In other words, what is the expected or the predicted value, right? So basically, it's pretty easy. All you do is plug it in, right? So miles per gallon predicted would be equal 46.87 minus 0.084 times 200. So if you use a calculator, supposed to get 30.07 miles per gallon. So how do we say this? We expect or we predict 200 horsepower car to use 30.07 miles per gallon. All right, next question B, what is the slope? See, by definition, it just kind of like think of by definition, the coefficient of X is always the slope. And of course, this is Y intercept. So the slope here will be the coefficient of X, which is right there. So the slope is just going to be negative, don't forget the negative, 0.084. Right? And then it says, explain what the slope means. I mean, what's interpretation of slope? So the way to interpret the slope, by the way, we call it B1. So this is B1. We don't call it like college algebra, we call it M. Now we want to call it B1. So that's the slope. Now the slope is, or B1, is negative 0.084, which is the same thing as negative 0.084 over 1. Remember, this is always change in Y, in predicted Y, over change in X. Right, or y2 minus y1, y2 hat minus y1 hat over x2 minus x1. So how do we interpret? We always say for each x, so in this case, think of x is changing by one unit. The y hat is changing by 0.084. So for each increase, definition is right here, for each increase of one unit. So in this case, I would say for each horsepower increase or additional horsepower, for each additional horsepower or horsepower increase, now the key here, because we're using y hat, not y, we have to use the term predict, right? So we predict or we expect, predict probably better, we predict the y value to decrease because it's a negative, so we say decrease. If it was positive, we say increase by 0.084. So predict, what is the y? Is the car miles per gallon? We predict that the car miles per gallon to decrease by 0.084 miles per gallon. And that's it for this example.